You know what's worse than spending hours editing a video? It's finally finishing it and nobody notices how hard you work on it. No comments about your slick transitions, no DMs asking you how you made it so clean, just silence. Because here's the truth, your edits can still look cool, but still fail. If your video confuses people, if it drags, if the visuals feel random, people will click away. And all the hours you spend editing just go to waste. I know this because it happened to me too. I was working hours editing a video and nobody noticed. It was all until I made these changes that I'm gonna show you today that made the shift for me. And I was finally getting the recognition and the money I wanted. And I want this for you too. But this video won't be about fancy gear or plugins. It will be about how you can make each frame count in your videos so your edits feel clean, cinematic, and impossible to ignore. Phase 1, design. If you follow this step and the last step, you'll already be better than 99% of the editors out there. So, after cutting your video, just pause and ask yourself, where does it slow down, confuse, or need visuals for clarity? And that's exactly where you will start to make your visuals. Now, go onto your timeline at the first marker and just ask yourself, what visual would represent best what it said here? If you do this, you completely eliminate the guesswork on what to do in your edit. This is how you become a top-tier editor. You stop adding random stuff with no plan. Once you've marked where to add the key animation, use design to highlight a specific word or part of your edit. For example, in this animation, what I wanted to highlight, I just left it colored. The rest, I just desaturated. Now, want to draw the viewer's eye dead center? Add subtle lines or arrows pointing inwards. Contrast makes things eye-catching. And as a rule to remember, and please write this down, one bold design choice beats a thousand effects. Phase 2, animation. Right now you know where to add your graphics, and you've designed your graphics. Now all we have to do is animate it. If nothing moves, your video feels paused, and viewers will either scroll away or zone out. But adding movement doesn't mean adding explosions or fireworks. Subtle motion is way more powerful. So here are the three rules for subtle movement. Rule 1. Easy ease. Linear keyframes feel like slamming the brakes out of nowhere. You ever been in a car with someone who suddenly accelerates or brakes for no reason? That's exactly what the viewers feel when your motion feels choppy or too abrupt. It pulls them out of the experience. But eased curves feel smooth and controlled, professional. They let the movement start slowly, build up naturally. So, open the graph editor, select your keyframes, and apply easy ease. Pull the influence handles into a smooth S-curve. Rule number 2. No dead frames. Even a small movement can make a shot feel alive. For example, you can add a simple 2% zoom in over a 10 second period, so you make the talking heads feel a bit more dynamic. But remember, you can always break rules if you want to enhance your edit in a specific way. Rule number 3. Lead the eye with motion. Motion amplifies your design direction. Let me give you an example. Look at this. You don't know where to look, but to get you to read the specific text I want, watch what happens next. I slide the shape towards it, and your eyes instinctively follow. Here's another example. In Inglourious Basterds, there's a scene where a Nazi officer is talking to a French farmer. At first, it seems like a polite conversation, but it slowly starts hinting that the officer knows that the farmer is hiding something, a Jewish family under the floorboards. As the officer speaks, the camera slowly zooms in on his face. It moves closer and closer, while he just stays calmly and smiles.
I might add also that any information that makes a performance of my duty easier will not be met with punishment. Actually, quite the contrary, it will be met with reward. You're sheltering enemies of the state, are you not?
Yes.
The slow zoom makes us feel trapped. Like the former, but it builds tension because we know something bad is going to happen. But we don't know exactly when. The closer the camera gets, the more intense it feels. It forces the viewer to pay attention and makes them feel the pressure. But here's the biggest lessons. Choose your hero moments. Don't animate everything. If everything is moving, nothing stands out. Trust stillness. The contrast between calm and energetic is what makes a video engaging. Now, rule number four, keeping your animations cohesive. Your animations should actually feel like they belong in the same world. You don't want text flying like a TikTok effect and X1 feeling cinematic. That makes your video feel disconnected. Make sure you use similar design elements in your videos. Keep the same easing, color scheme and motion style. It's not about how cool each animation looks on its own, it's about how they all work together. So, if you want your edits to feel cohesive, after 6 years of editing, of gathering all my favorite assets, I made this pack for you, the Ultimate Creator Toolkit. This pack is made so everything feels cohesive and expansive. Titles, backgrounds, overlays, sound design and more. No more remaking the same thing from scratch, no more random effects that just don't work in your edit. I can't tell you how many hours this saves me every time I edit. All the text animations you see in this video are in the pack. Just drag and drop, tweak the sliders and you're done. And just because you are watching this video, I will give you 20% off. You have a link in the description. And now, let's go on to phase 3. Sound is what holds everything together. It's the special sauce that most editors miss. The two most common mistakes I see are 1. The music is too loud, and 2, the sound just sounds super corporate or boring. Now, here's how to fix it. Find the right track. Now, music should match the feeling in your video and support it, not compete with it. So if your edit is cinematic and personal, don't slap some fast-paced EDM music. And if it's fast and energetic, don't put some slow piano sound. You'll know you find the right song when it just disappears in your edit and gives you energy. So, here's how to set your music levels. Forget about the exact dB. Play your edit like you're the viewer. Headphones on. Volume at a normal level. If you ever find yourself paying more attention to the song than the voice, it's probably too loud. Now, the last thing about the music, add sound effects, please. Sound effects are the thing that makes an edit feel expensive. Soft whoosh when things move. A low rumble during key moments. A tap or click when a graphic appears. These small audio touches just take your edit from normal to professional. And as a bonus, but it could be phase 4, this is not a technical thing, but it changes everything. Great editors don't learn from doom scrolling. If your inspiration is a 10 second meme, expect 10 second attention spans. Instead, actually watch people that push the boundaries on YouTube, that make art. This will train your subconscious to want to make art as well. Screenshot good design moments and ask yourself, why is that effect there? How would I have done it better than him? The thing is, you are not watching to copy effects. You are watching to get inspired. Study greatness, steal ideas, and make them yours. Now you have everything you need. You know how to design with purpose, animate with intention, and make your sound feel awesome. As a next step, just feed your brain with good content. It won't happen overnight, but your edits will consistently improve. I really hope you find it useful, and if you want the easy way to make your edits feel cohesive and stop the guesswork, make sure you check the pack that I made for you. It's the first link in the description. I really appreciate you and I believe in you. Thank you for watching.